the beat. Don't let that fine girl pass you by. Look real close, cause strobe lights.
We about to have a party. Let's get it started. I'm looking for a girl with a body and a sexy strut. Wanna get it popping, baby, step right
some
up.
Some girls, they act retarded. Some girls are body, body. I'm looking for a girl that will do whatever the fuck I say every day. She be giving it up. Shake that ass for me. Shake that ass for me. Come on, girl, shake that ass for me. Shake that ass for me. Oh, girl, shake that ass for me. Shake that ass for me. Come on, girl, shake that ass for me. Shake that ass for me.
I'm a menace, a dentist, and on hygienist. Open your mouth for about 4 or 5 minutes. Take a little bit of this fluoride riddance. Swish, but don't spit it. Swallow it, now finish. Yeah. Looking at Neo Double G. Looking for a couple bitches with some double D's. Pop a little champagne and a couple D's. Slipping in the bubbly. We finna
about to have a party. Let's get it started.
Go ahead, shake it.
I'm looking for a girl like a fuck in my Hummer truck. Apple bottom jeans and a big old sweater.
Think I'm retarded.
I want a bitch to sit at the crib with no panties on. Knows that she can, but she won't say no. Look at this lady on front of me. Sexy as can be. Tonight I want a slut. Would you be mine? Heard you was freaky from a friend of mine. Now I hope you gon' get mad at me. But I told Nate you was a freak. He said he wants a slut. Hope you don't mind. I told him how you like it from behind.
Shake that ass for me. Shake that ass for me. Come on, girl, shake that ass for me. Shake that ass for me. Oh, girl, shake that ass for me. Shake that ass for me. Come on, girl, shake that ass for me. Shake that ass for me. We about to have a party.
Turn the music.
Let's get it started.
Go ahead, shake your butt.
I'm looking for a girl with a body and a sexy strut. Wanna get it poppin', baby, step right up.
Some girls, they act retarded.
Some girls are body, body. I'm looking for a girl that will do whatever the fuck I say every day. She'll be giving it.
She go shaking that ass on the floor, bumping and grinding that pole. The way she's grinding that pole, I think I'm losing control.
Also, your glasses, by the way, are amazing.
Oh,
I love them.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So are you all visiting? You from here?
All from San Diego.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. What brings you to the zoo today? Thank you.
Animals.
Animals. Any favorites?
Monkeys.
Monkeys. Nice. Thank you. Thanks.
I'm also a big fan of killer whales, but no whales here.
You know, so my background is actually in the marine science. I spent about 5 years working at an aquarium. So if you have weird fishy questions, I'm your lady.
Have you seen Shamu?
I actually met Shamu before I moved out for a while, so I knew Shamu when I was really little. There's this like picture of me as like a kid, like up against the wall, like just splattered with wet. Have you seen the at SeaWorld?
TT, I don't know when to go live at this point.
Oh, they are.
I know, but I don't know when to cut because the audio is just.
Okay, so we're actually one whole big group here. We are a packed car, so we're gonna be right on this. Little cheetah print cart.
Oh, yeah.
And all seats are here, including the one next to me, so feel free to sit next to me if you'd like.
Should I sit with her?
Are you live?
I'm live.
You sit with her.
Oh, you are live?
Yeah. I shouldn't sit with her?
No, because then you won't be able to be with
her. Do we get off the car?
We do. So we're going to be mostly on the vehicle, but we do have to.
Should I sit with her?
That we're going to take.
No, because then we can't sit here. We'll be alone. But whatever. Yeah,
whatever. I'm going to sit with her.
Dennis, what's up, man?
Oh, no. Hi.
Hey, yo. Fuck Uncle Sam. That's a sub.
Thank you.
Yeah, dude.
Okay, I got to get on this car.
Yeah, man. It was great to meet
nice
you.
Nice meeting you. Thanks you for the money.
You got me 2020 deployment, bro.
Right on, dude. Thank you. Oh, Jesus.
Are you famous? Am I secretly in here as a famous person?
No. You don't have people give money to start something?
Alright, y'all. Alrighty, everybody. So like I said earlier, my name is Crystal. I'll be your guide today. I'm super excited. The surprise tours are some of my favorites because you never know what's going to happen. So I'm going to lead you through like it is a surprise. Unless somebody has a dying need, then you can pull me aside at one of the stops
Hey guys, the audio's gonna suck. The microphone just stopped working as I'm also riding up front with the lady. And if the audio sucks, it's too bad. Just TT, end the stream.
These sorts of tours, I think, is how involved you can be. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask away. I love talking, so you'll have to remind me to calm down, everybody, because I will talk your
I'm so crammed in here. I'm so crammed. I'm gonna flirt with the lady, though. Oh, sure.
Great, because I can drive great, but sometimes the animals
so okay.
I'm going to rely on you as my
Can I put my phone here?
Yeah, absolutely. Do whatever you need to be cozy.
Okay.
Okay. Can you hear me all right back there? Perfect. Is it super loud?
No.
Okay, just checking. Sometimes I get a little overly excited. So we're going to cruise on through here. Going into our bus depot first so that we can get to some of the great stuff on the other side here. So I promise it only goes up from here. Now our zoo, since it's new to some of the folks here, but we do have some folks here from San Diego. Have you been to this zoo before?
Yes.
Nice. Wonderful. We're going to scooch right on over here to the side here so that our bus can make it through. We got to share some space, so I'm just going to kind of pull forward, and then I'll back up here. So it makes a fun little backup noise. Perfect. Thank you so much.
Look at the socks. What kind of socks are those?
I actually have no idea, but they look a lot like
Hi! 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 Hi!
Back in 1916. So we are just a little over 100 years old here at the zoo. And one thing that I really, really love about us is actually how we've changed during that time. When we first opened up, we were a place that you could come to look at animals. And that's really important. It serves a great purpose. But since we've been around for about 100 years, we've had a lot of time to sort of think things through a little deeper. And now we look at our animals almost like ambassadors for their species out in the wild. So as we go through, I'll tell you a little bit how we do research on our animals, the conservation efforts that we're doing both here in San Diego and all around the world. But, you know, you don't do like 100 years of research on animals without learning silly and fun things as well. So I'm hoping I will also get to share some of those silly fun facts, too. We're headed down our Center Street area first. Center Street used to be called Bear Canyon, and you might notice a trend while we're down Center Street that it definitely has quite a few bears living on it. So we're going to start first by looking off to the right here in a moment.
Whoa.
We're trying to find some lost bear.
Ooh.
Any luck?
No.
No, I'm not seeing anybody yet either.
No.
You know, if we don't see things, we can just keep going because there is so much for us to see here at the zoo. So we'll keep cruising.
Okay.
It might be sloth bear nap time. We do find that a lot of times our animals, especially as the days start to get a little bit warmer, will be kind of behind the scenes in their like den areas as well.
So we'll
keep cruising. I'm not seeing anybody in here either. Now that one's not surprising to me because she's actually just visiting. So we did just pass by an area where we do have a tiger. Our tiger is not out so much there. Her name's Batari. She's just visiting from
Oh, that's a bear.
We've got a couple of grizzly bears
lovely family
here. We call them our grizzly boys. Their names are Scout and Montana. Oh, here he comes a little bit. Nice little wobble.
Yo.
You can see that healthy layer of fat right there wiggling around.
Same.
Oh, yeah. What's that? Yes, feel free. Thank you for asking.
Yo, that's a bear.
It's a whole bear. This is one of our, it's either Scout or Montana or Grizzly Boys. They are here actually because they were nuisance bears. Have you ever heard the term nuisance animal before?
Yeah. Annoying?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, nuisance does mean kind of annoying, right? So as a nuisance bear, they were actually going and finding people and people's spaces.
You see the koala girl?
So they were like real life Yogi Bear, if you're familiar at all with that cartoon. They would go find people's picnics and eat them. Now, that's not super safe for people, and it's definitely not safe for the bears. So we were really lucky that we got to rehome and house them here. They were living right outside of Yellowstone, too, in Idaho. So over in a national park, it's pretty easy to find people. Okay, directly in the middle.
There's a sleeping bear!
I've got one coming for you.
Augie is an Andean bear, so he's living up in the rainforests of the Andes.
Wait, that's a bear Andy right there?
Yeah, it's an Andean bear.
Oh, Andean bear.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a bear.
Bear Andy.
Well, his name is Augie. Augie, yeah, short for Agapito. And Augie is a brand new adult. He has only just started living on his own recently. He's a whole 2 years old. So now he's an adult. So he was living with mom. Mom is actually now living behind the scenes so that they can each have their own space. And he does live next door to dad. So we'll see if we can find dad next.
Hello. Hello. You gotta drive away when I say hi. I'm sorry.
I'm just gonna hit a stroller.
Fair, fair.
Oh, there he is. Oh, here he goes. He's like right in his hammock. It kind of looks like you just need to give him a remote, you know?
Okay, bro, you gotta move, bro. You gotta move.
Now you might notice what he's sitting in too.
No, you're good. You're good.
And his hammock is actually made of recycled and reused
get out of the fucking
fire
way,
hoses.
Dude. I'll kill you.
We have an interesting little connection with our local fire department where we're able to sort of trade off things. So they give us their old fire hoses that they can't use anymore. So since San Diego and Southern California is almost always on fire, we have a very active fire department. However, there's only so many uses you can get out of a fire hose before you are no longer allowed to use them for the potential to burst, so it becomes unsafe. Our bears, they needed something to play with that was going to be durable enough for a bear to play with, and we just needed a lot of it because they go through a lot of those materials. So to help create that enrichment, we actually partner with our local fire departments so they can give us their old stuff and give it a second life.
That's good. That's crazy.
One of my favorite things. Okay. We're now at the bottom of Center Street. We're going to cruise through our Asian Passage area.
What?
This space is called Asian Passage.
Hmm.
So it's kind of nice. Our zoo is shaped a little bit like a bowl. And this is actually the bottom of that bowl. So right here it tends to be a little bit cooler. You might already be feeling that breeze. It doesn't usually get too much cooler, but like about 5 or so degrees. So now we're kind of like the nice little spot, of course, so that you don't have to walk all the way down and up the bowl. We are passing underneath a
bridge, and there is also an elevator over here to the left as well. So the elevator takes you to the start of the bridge, which is over by Albert's and our gorillas. And then if you cross over the bridge, it'll take you towards our elephant area, which is where we are headed next.
We're in the Asian bowl, so. Their diet.
Their diet, you're exactly right. they eat a lot of shrimp and krill that's super high in this stuff called beta carotene. And the beta carotene is what turns them pink. We're about to see some flamingo on the left in just a moment that live a slightly different lifestyle. And I want you to tell me.
It's like Joe Rogan with Alpha Brain.
Anything different. So
that's why he looks like a thumb.
Right,
and they eat beta. Team. That's why they're pink. He drinks alpha. Get it? It's a joke.
What do you notice?
I can't see.
Oh, sorry. We'll keep going.
That's okay.
Yeah, I love that. So we're noticing that they're not nearly as pink, but they're mostly white, but they still have a little bit of pink, right? These are actually African flamingos called greater flamingo, and they eat algae. So there's a lot less of that beta carotene in them to turn them pink. So they are exactly the right color for them, even though they look a lot different than what we normally think of.
I'm being told the camera is failing. Suck my dick. Nothing I can do about it. I'm on a car. I'm trapped.
In it. Any guesses? Off of the word carotene.
Carrots?
Yeah, it is carrot. it'll turn you a little yellow, but you have to eat like a literal ton of carrots. I had a pediatrician on one of my tours. And they were telling me that they see it happen a lot with kids because, you know, you have to eat less when you're small to get the color. If their kids eat so many carrots, they turn a little yellow.
Yes. Yes, please.
So we are about 100 acres here at the zoo. We're huge. We tried expanding even further until we couldn't expand anymore. So on your left, you might see some Mustangs or Rams because those are the names. We've got Highway 163 over there, and so we could not grow any further, but if you ever drive on 163, you can wave at the zoo. Sometimes the zoo waves back. As we make our way through here, we are going to pass by this section of Northern Frontier, where on the left, this is where our polar bears live, and on the right, we're going to pass Hoofstock. So animals with hooves for feet. Now, our polars, they actually, we've got three of those bears here. And even though we're in San Diego where it's really hot and polars are Arctic species, you'd imagine they'd be pretty uncomfortable. But they've been living here since they were just a couple of months old. All three of them are rescues. One was a nuisance bear. The other two, actually, their mother was poached, but we knew where her den was, so we were able to go and collect her, or collect them. I don't know what exciting things have happened over here, but maybe we can see. I'm going to pause us really quick. They're a little bit down the hill. Those are Bontebok in that area. They're in Hoofstock. I'm not seeing them, so
hello.
Keep cruising.
Hello.
Hi.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Hi. Hello.
But our polars are actually so accustomed to the San Diego weather that even though they have a refrigerated den area and ice machines that run all the time, if the water dips below 55 degrees, they won't go in anymore, which is pretty funny. You'd assume that they would like it because they are Arctic species. Over here on the right with those cute little horns, that's a Guarana.
Oh, it's Danny.
Guarana are really funny, so they actually do this behavioral adaptation where they eat leaves out of trees. So if they can't reach those trees, they'll come up onto their hind legs to reach a little further to get to their food. But here, they never do that for their food. They do it mostly to check in on their neighbors. They're so nosy. It's pretty cute. On the right, all the way in the back, you can kind of see some peccary or javelina having a snooze.
No.
And those guys back there that look kind of like they've just discovered hair gel, love them. Their nickname are deer pig, and that's because they're actually more closely related to deer than pig, which bothers me every time I see them because they look like boars. Okay. What's that?
We have a friend that looks like a deer.
That's awesome.
Yeah, she's great.
So as we cruise through here, look up at the top of the rocks, and we might see, they were out earlier, but usually they're kind of hiding away. We've got a couple of mountain lions that live in here. They're sisters, Sierra Sierra and Tahoe. And so Sierra and Tahoe were also nuisance animals, but mountain lions have over 40 recognized names. Do you know another name for a mountain lion?
Cougar.
Bobcat. Ooh, that's pretty close. That one's actually a different one. Have you ever heard of a puma? Same cat. Have you ever heard of a ghost cat? Florida panther, catamount, or wampus cat. Those are all the mountain lions. They've got a lot of different names. Okay, we are making our way. We are now in the behind-the-scenes area for our Elephant Odyssey. Now, this space was created to kind of show what San Diego used to look like in the Pleistocene era, so about 12,000 years ago. So while we no longer have these animals here today, the fossil evidence from places like La Brea Tar Pits is showing us that we used to at one point. So we're looking for anything lying around over here.
You're crazy, dude.
Sometimes they're asleep right under here. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Here's Ernest.
Oh, yo, go.
Look at the moss on
so that here's guy. Ernest's butt. Sorry, he's not showing us a more flattering side.
Boy is fully
Ernest
loaded.
Here, he lives
see
in
it.
Here with his sister, Miss Ellen. I didn't quite see her anywhere. But these animals, they're about 350 to 400 pounds. And do you see that mane kind of sticking up?
Yeah.
Just the mane around his neck weighs about 80 pounds.
What the hell?
And they use it as armor.
I can't even see it
so
either.
So the girls, they don't have that mane, right? They're doing a lot of running. They don't need that extra 80 pounds. Whereas for the males, since they will get into fights with each other where they go after the neck of the animal that they're fighting, they use that armor all the way around his neck where he's the male.
Do you want to just see mine instead?
It's really, really densely packed.
So the males don't run as much as the girls?
The men don't run almost at all. So the females do exclusive hunting.
What?
And expect, you know, and then the males protect the pride. So she will leave her young at the pride to be protected by the males. And in return, she's bringing home the bacon. Okay, on the right, we're looking for another cat. Sometimes she's hanging out inside this little cave, so I'll drive really slow by it. You're getting a little bit of her.
Oh, you can sort of see.
I'll go nice and slow. But inside the cave, you can see some paws and a little booty of Nindiri. Nindiri is a South American jaguar. And even though she's pretty tiny, she's actually our fiercest cat. If you make a fist with your hand and like squeeze really, really hard, the human hand generates about 50 to 70 pounds of pressure
per square inch. I can't say anything.
And then I'm basing this off of the bite of the cats. So even Ernest next door with his big muscular face, he's getting to about 900 pounds of pressure. And in theory, even though she's so much smaller, she generates about 1,300 pounds of pressure in her bite. She's the fiercest. She actually breaks through bone when she hunts, rather than going for softer parts like most other cats will. She goes straight for the head. Yeah, she's definitely super fierce. She's tiny, but she's coming in with a sassy little punch. And we are coming towards our very first stop off here. So we are going to go into the lobby of the Elephant Care Center. So we'll start there, and then we'll come on out and see if we can find any of those elephants. So I'm going to park us right here, and we're going to just cross the street towards those stairs.
Can you hold this for a second?
Hold on.
Dude, my ass is so sweaty.
Really?
Yeah.
I was gonna say, it's really nice and cool.
Oh, well, good for you.
Well, maybe she's sat in the back.
Well, I'm having a great time with whatever her name is. I can't see anything.
Yeah.
No,
I can't see a thing.
Yeah,
we paid for this?
No, it's because we're nice to this
one. Oh. What is it we're doing?
We want to see the elephants right now.
Do we get a ride one?
No.
Why not?
Do we get to ride one?
Employees only. Uh-oh. I'm not. I don't work here.
So go ahead on in and let me know what you notice when you're in there.
What the? And enjoy the zoo.
Yeah, so can you imagine what a whole tooth might feel like? Feel free to
knock somebody out. Let's see. Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's heavy.
Is it?
Yeah. Oh, feet up, I said.
So when you say it's temporary, you need
tooth?
Today's.
Yes.
I want to heal
so
a tooth.
It's heavy, watch out.
It's a tooth.
In there, did you see the task you're welcome to reach in there as well?
She did.
There's some tasks there. Did you get a chance to get
Is this real life?
It is real. So the tusk is a modified tooth. And actually what's interesting is they're made of the same stuff as our own teeth. They're just a lot bigger. So it's dentine covered in a layer of enamel.
That's so very soft.
Yeah.
That's how it is.
It's super real. Oh. That's its actual tusk. You're welcome to reach out.
That's not like
sanded it.
Yeah.
No, they're really just that.
Good call.
Now, the other thing I find really
what's
interesting about
I'm just going to do this.
Nothing works.